Next is on pastries. Next is on pastries. We have different types of pastries. And today, we are on a short crust pastry. Short crust pastry. The ingredients are salt flour, margarine, and salt. We are making savory pastry. Savory pastry because it doesn't contain any sugar. So we are starting with the pastry. And this pastry, we are going to fry it. So it doesn't need much fat. The difference between the fried pastry and the baked pastry is that the baked pastry, you get 2 parts of the flour to a part of the fat because it's being baked. But for the fried one, it's 2 parts to half of the fat because it's going to the oil. And if the fat is too much, they will disintegrate into the oil. So we are measuring 200 grams of flour. I have here a scale, a kitchen scale, the metric kitchen scale. Then we also have the measuring cup. This one is in the imperial system. That is the ounces and the pounds. So you can get this. Or if you don't have any of these, you can go for the one they use in the market. That's the cup. We have to use if the need arises, you can, if you buy a cup of flour, then I will tell you the measurement for the fat. So here we have the measuring cup as well as the kitchen scale. So for the flour, we need the salt flour, then it has to be flavored. Then we have nutmeg. We add nutmeg to flavor. What we are doing now is a basic recipe. We need 200 grams. And if you are using the cup, make sure when you place the flour into the cup, you don't tilt it up. It should be placed on the flat surface and make sure you shake it. You shake it, then you place it there and you go down and read. You shouldn't hold it and read or it will give you a wrong reading. So we are using the scale as well as the cup. Please, no guesswork, or you won't get the best result. No guesswork. For the flour, it has been measured 8 ounces or 200 grams. That's the metric one. This one has to be sieved or sifted. The main reason we sieve the flour or sift it is to aerate it. We have to introduce air. So after the finished product, you can see that it becomes light and increase in size and also in volume. That's the main reason we use raising agents in flour products. So when I'm sifting the flour, I'm introducing air into the mixture. At the same time, any foreign materials will be in the mesh. It won't go into the basin. So any foreign material like this will be here. So it have not been sifted or sieved, then everything will go into the flour. Then for the margarine, because I said this one is going to be fried, there should be less fat. So for short crust pastries, the ratio is 2 parts of the flour to a part of the margarine. That is, that one is baked. So if it's being fried, it should be 2:1/2 of the fat, because the oil is also a type of a fat. For the short crust pastry, I've already said, it's 2 parts of the flour to a part of the margarine, if it is baked. But if it's being fried, you have to reduce the fat so that they will not disintegrate into the oil. So it's 2:1/2 of the fat. So if you take this, if you ask for this type of spoon, a serving spoon, is being found in all homes. So this one is easy to get. So if you measure to this quantity, this one is 2 ounces or 50 grams to 200 grams or 8 ounces. So this one goes into the flour. Then we also need nutmeg. We have to flavor the pastry. Just a pinch of that. Then you use the fingertips to rub in the fat to the flour. So as what I'm doing now, I'm also introducing air into the mixture. So after everything, then you get the best results. So you have to rub in so that the mixture looks like a fine breadcrumbs or a fine gari. The nutmeg, you have to use the nut one and make sure you grate into a container like this. Then use just a pinch. Just a pinch. That one will bring out more flavor. Apart from the nutmeg, you can also use extra flavoring like a blended onion. It all depends on individual choice. You can only use the nutmeg, or you can also add a blended onion. Add blended onion. The onion, garlic can also be added according to individual choice. Garlic can also be added. Just a little, not too much. Not too much of the onions. So after mixing, let's see. Then add a little salt, either to the mixture or can be added to water, which we are going to use to make the dough. Please don't add too much water, it becomes sticky. Just sprinkle a little water at a time and make sure you don't press it hard, or else you extract the air will be excluded. We shouldn't be like that. You use the tip of the fingers to form the dough after you have sprinkled the water. The tip of the fingers, you shouldn't handle too much or becomes tough. After everything, the pastry will become tough. to make a soft dough, but not too much. Don't add too much water. So after this, we are going to allow it to rest for some time for the gluten to relax. We mention gluten because when flour is mixed with water, there's protein in flour, which is called gluten, which makes it elastic. So we want it to relax. The gluten has to relax for some time. That's why we allow it to rest before we use it for what we need it for. Place the dough in a poly bag for about 5 to 10 minutes before rolling. This is the soft dough which we are going to roll to make a variety of chips. So this is a rolling pin. This is a metal rolling pin. We have other rolling pins. It's a metal rolling pin. We have the plastic rolling pin as well as the wooden rolling pin. And this is a chopping board. So if you don't have a chopping board, you can use a wooden small table for the rolling. And you have to dust the surface of the chopping board with a little of the flour so that the pastry will not stick. Then you don't press it too much. It should be done gently. Gentle rolling. Then if you want to turn to the other side, you don't lift it, you just roll on the pin, then it goes down. Make sure the pastry should not be overhandled or become tough. So this one we are going to use the pasta machine for the cutting. And this is a pasta machine. This is a special machine. This is a special machine we use to cut the pastry. Then we divide into two. Then this one is placed. There are three sections on the pasta machine. This side is meant for the rolling. This one is for the normal cutting. And this one is for the fine cutting. So if you want to roll, this is the handle we normally use to operate. So let me show you how to use it. So if this one is for rolling, then it goes in like this, then you turn. This is manual. See that it has really stretched. That's really stretched than the first one we used the rolling pin. So this one is time for the cutting. So you fix the handle to the machine, then this is the result. You get strands of the pastry. So this is another way of making the variety. It's another way. If you don't have the machine, you can use the knife. The knife to cut. So you cut into strips. Can use the knife or the scissors. So this is how we do with the knife. Make sure they have the same size, or else if some are bigger than the other, you have the small, the bigger ones. The smaller ones will cook fast and they will burn before the bigger ones will cook. So if you don't have the pasta machine, you can use the knife to cut or the scissors. The scissors is the same thing. Make sure you should have a special scissors in the kitchen, not the one you use in the bathroom or somewhere else, but it should be. Should keep these scissors in the kitchen for this purpose. And now of making the pastry, this one you are going to make it into flakes. You tear them into smaller pieces. Then this one, you roll. Make sure when you're rolling, you stretch. So it becomes very light. This is how it should look like. Or you can roll it more so that after frying, it becomes flaky. You call it flutes. It's another way of making the flute pastry. The pastry that we prepared and cut, it's not the time to be fried. It's deep fried. You get enough saucepan. The saucepan, it all depends on the oil you have. If you have a little, you don't have enough oil, then you need a saucepan which you can contain, because when you are deep frying, you divide the pan into three, so the oil should take to pass, because when the content goes into the oil, it will rise. So if you fill the pan to almost to the brim, when you put in the food, it will bubble over into the fire. So now the oil is heated enough, so we place a little to test if it is all right. So our oil is all right. You shouldn't place too much, because you if you can remember, we introduce air. So if you have introduced air, it means the mixture will increase in size. So this is the tool for stirring. This is a spider. This is a spider, and this is a perforated spoon. This is a spider, and this is a perforated spoon. Any of these can be used to stir. So if I should have placed everything, then it won't get enough room to be cooked. So you fry a little at a time. It all depends on the size of the pan and the oil. And after it has been fried, it should go into a colander. This is a colander. This one is not used to strain palm pulp. This one is meant for frying. You, after everything, you place it into it for the oil to drain into the bowl beneath. And also remember, because it's a starch product, if it stays in the oil for a longer period and it becomes a dark brown, after you have removed from the fire, the heat in the food will still continue. So we shouldn't allow it to become dark brown before you remove. It should be a golden brown color before you remove it from the fire. So this should be the color. So allow the oil to regain its heat before adding the second batch. For the flaky one, you tear into the oil. You can make into bigger sizes or smaller sizes. You shouldn't place too much. Thank you.